met us after all these years together. Look at us after all that we've been through. Look at us still leaning on each other. If you want to see how true love should be, then just look at us.
And Father Lord, most of all, we thank you for the lives that have been touched in the marriage of these two couples. Thank you, Father Lord, for all those who are spending eternity in heaven because of their witness. We thank you, Father Lord, that yes, they've been through difficult times, tough times, they've been through good times. Father Lord, they've joined hands and they've fought the battles together. We give you all the honor for that today, all the honor of this marriage. And we ask your Holy Spirit to be upon you today. Dad, I'd like to look here, look everyone in the face here, because they've all taken time to be here today. And I want you to acknowledge them. That's very important. And then I want to start this. I want to share something with you. Mike and Diana got married. When they got married, they were heathen people. They did not know Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Mike had been to church some. I don't think Diana had been to church much at all. The reason I'm bringing this up, it's because after 50 years of marriage, we truly realize that their marriage is a testimony about the transforming power of Jesus Christ. When they first got married, Mike could not love Diana with the love of Jesus. He couldn't. He loved her a lot, but he did not have Jesus. The same thing applies to Diana. She loved him a lot, but she could not love him with the love of Jesus because Jesus was not living in her. Now, when these two got saved, they were radically saved. Radically saved. And I've known them for quite a few years. They are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. They're not ashamed to tell people what Jesus Christ has done in their life. And I just want to thank them tonight for 50 years. 50 years of fighting it out. Thank you very much. Now, would you just kind of face me here just for a moment? Mike and Diana, as you stand here today to reaffirm your vows made 50 years ago, you have matured and are much wiser, we hope. This evening, as you repeat your wedding vows, you will have already experienced a covenant marriage relationship and found it to be good. That's the right time, Michael. The maturity that has developed during the past 50 years gives you a more profound understanding of words such as submit, love, cherish, faithful, patient, and kind. You have both learned that to make a successful marriage requires effort, commitment, and most of all, Jesus Christ. Mike, do you take Diana as your wife, as your own flesh, to love her even as Christ loves the church, promising to keep, cherish, and defend her, and to be her faithful and true husband so long as you both shall live? Mike, will you repeat after me? I, Mike, join myself to you, Diana.
Join myself to you, Diana.
You are a treasure, given to me from God. I shall continue to be the husband God has called me to be. Diana, do you take Mike as your husband, submitting yourself unto him as unto the Lord, showing reverence to him as the head of this union for the rest of your lives, promising to love and honor him and to be his loving and true wife as long as you both shall live? Now, Diana, will you repeat after me? I, Diana, according to the Word of God, submit myself to you, Mike, to be a wife to you, as we have been one in spirit and flesh, so shall we continue to be. So, as this ring has been placed on his finger, say this to him. With this ring, I thee wed. I reaffirm to you that this is forever.
Adam's side, God formed his bride as beautiful as could be. Standing here beside you, I see he's done the same for me. I waited such a long time, and I can't believe it's true. But by my side, God's placed a bride as beautiful as you.
I just want to share one last thing to every man here. The greatest thing you can do today for your wife, if you're not a Christian, would be to meet Jesus Christ. To every wife, I say here today, the greatest thing you can do for your husband, if you don't know Jesus Christ, would be to meet him today. Now let's just give the Lord another hand clap for this brother's supper.
Look at us, still leaning on each other. If you wanna see how true love should be, then just look at us. Look at you, still pretty. Look at me.